problem doesn't exist.
Now, back to the news I mentioned earlier. Sydney got a touch of royalty today.
Last time Prince William was in Australia, people lined the streets to get a glimpse of the young prince. 25 years on, and it seems Aussies have lost interest in the man who could be our future king. Here on a privately funded trip, today he lunched with our Delta, tomorrow he's meeting our soldiers. But does anyone really care?
I didn't even know Prince William was here, to be honest.
Definitely a Harry fan.
Nice enough bloke, nothing personal, but couldn't give a flying.
So with Aussies snubbing the young royal, could the prince be feeling more like a pauper?
For his thoughts, we now cross to Jai Martinkovits from Australians for a Constitutional Monarchy. Jai, thanks for joining us tonight. Tell us, why do we even need the royals?
The royals play a significant role in Australian life. Essentially, they provide a check and balance on a system so that we don't have corruption in our politicians. If we were to remove that check and balance, it would be something that would give us a huge period of instability constitutionally that I certainly wouldn't want to be living under. So I think they play a very significant role.
Jai, when Prince William comes to visit Australia, do you think anyone's looking at him going, oh, thank God that check and balance has landed in our country?
I'm sure that's not the thing going through people's minds at all because they don't realise about it. But no, I think that people certainly welcome him quite warmly. As we can see, even from staunch Republicans, he's been welcomed with open arms.
Jai, were you part of the so-called frenzy there today in amongst that crowd of thousands out at the airport that didn't exist?
No, I wasn't part of any of the crowds today. I was doing a little bit more of media stuff, but I'm getting involved with some of that stuff tomorrow, so it should be a privilege.
On the topic of the popularity of the monarchy, a lot of polling lately, and also on our website, the polling that counts, suggests that most people would rather Prince William instead of Prince Charles to take over the monarchy. How do you feel about that?
Well, polling certainly fluctuates. I remember a poll back in November that suggested that there was almost up around 59% support for a republic of some sort. So you know, that's a freak poll. But in relation to your question on Prince Charles and Prince William, it's not so much the monarch that is at the head of the system, it's the system that's important. And whether it be Prince Charles or Prince William that we have, it's the system that counts.
You're a handsome young chap, Jai. Why do you care so much about such an ancient institution?
It's the checks and balances on our system. It basically, it provides us a stability. And, you know, if we were to invest all that power into a single person, or depending upon the model, even if we had a collective group of people who formed a body that made those decisions, we're not having someone external to politics. We're opening it up to too much influence from a political sense.
Well, Jai, thanks so much for joining us tonight. Obviously a hot topic, but, yeah, enjoy having the prince in town.
Yeah,
is he kidding himself or what?
I think he looks quite royal himself. Why not make the King Australian put that guy in charge? I like him.
I don't mind the idea of an Australian royal family at random. We pick a family every year and they get a year. Like, it's this year, the Bensons from Watsonia, and they're the royal family.
It's going to make our coin system really difficult, though. But you know what? Was there a frenzy? Steve, you mentioned there may not have been a frenzy. Let's have a look at the frenzy this morning when the prince touched down in Australia. Channel 9 was certainly trying to talk it up.
Unlike his arrival in New Zealand, which was pretty, average affair with no one turning out, quite a number of royal watchers have come down this morning to the Universal Terminal.
Yeah, and the number was 13.
And they were all queued up for the Krispy Kreme donuts out at the airport. That's what I drove past.
Can I just say, I saw footage later on in Redfern this afternoon. There was quite a few people there.
Yeah, but if you want to talk about crowds, I can actually go back to that first time he came here 27 years ago, back in 1983, and the crowds back then is what we should be comparing this with. The crowds back then, look at this, it was amazing. I was in that walk around there. I think that might have been Melbourne, just after the Ash Wednesday bushfires. They
well,
were
that
20
would have had to do with
deep.
Princess Di too, wouldn't it?
They came to see her. Look at her. She's gorgeous. Yeah, she was a superstar.
Prince Charles was pretty hot back then, surely.
But I mean, look at those crowds. You're never going to get that now. So 27 years on, the argument defeats itself from that clown we just had on. Because look at these people. They really believed in the royal family back then. You would not get a turnout like that now.
Do you think younger people now think of Prince William as more of a celeb than a royal? Like, you know, you've read about him in New Idea, you know he's dating Kate Middleton. It's not for his royalness that he
There's too many celebrities these days, no doubt about it.
I've got to say, I'm amazed there aren't bigger crowds because, like you mentioned, New Idea, they gave you the best way to show your appreciation of the Prince. If you cut out from New Idea this week, you've got the Prince flag, look at that. Flag one side, that's Prince on the other. And its instruction was, stick it to a chopstick, which I've done. Look at that. If he went past in a limo, that'd make his day.
Now, look, I'm going to go back to Channel 9 for a second. I don't want to pick on the reporter today. I think she had a tough job to talk it up at the airport. But she went early with her sighting of Prince William leaving the plane. Watch this.
Here we go now. I think he is coming out of the jet right now. It's difficult to see him. It seems as though he is wearing a suit and tie and is making his way. Oh, it's not him.
I think it's him because he's not there.
Right? Hard job to commentate. Cut us some slack.
We do have to take a break because we're perfect. We'll be back after this.
Next, what happens when Andrew comes face to face with Hannah Montana herself, Miley Cyrus? Find out after the break on the 7 p.m. Project.